Hey Ross World, my money makes money. Habit or hard work? You need to define, you need to find out a method to help your finances booster itself from where it's from right now. Now granted, we're not going to even talk about the stock market. For like the past 7 days, the stock market has been tanking. Do not get nervous. Do not move your money. Do not sell, okay? Because when you sell, that's when you lose money. When you sell a stock at a lower price than what you bought it. I'm off of it, but here's the thing. Sacrifices is the only way you're going to develop a good habit, because the habit that you're in now, whether it be breakfast sandwiches, morning coffees, morning teas, whatever it may be, you develop a routine and make it a habit in order to get where you are right now. So now what we have to do is start where we started before, and we make sacrifices. We have to get on a new routine. We have to start a new habit, and that takes hard work. So you're trying to figure out what's the best course of action. The best course of action, in my opinion, is those things that you do every single day out of routine. Maybe it's a social event with friends because you grab coffee. Maybe it's a lunch thing. You always go out to lunch. Maybe it's happy hour every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, like Mondays, hump days, and those Fridays. That rhymed. The point I'm making is this. You may have to stop there for a while. You may have to stop there for a while to get your finances in shape, to get your finances in order. And once you make that sacrifice, it becomes habit and it won't hurt as much. You just love spending time with your friends. You just love spending time with your family. You just love spending time with your siblings or your significant other. But you may have to find out a different method in order to save some money, in order to pay off your debt. So if you buy coffee every day, buy your coffee, bring it home. What I mean is go to the grocery store, buy your coffee, and bring it home. That is what I mean. Make your coffee at home. But you're just like, oh, I love the way this person made coffee. I love the way that person made coffee. Now, granted, if you love that coffee and you just can't have any other type of coffee, then figure out how to make it. I remember I fell in love with Ruth Crisp sweet potato souffle or whatever it was, whatever they called it. And it's quite expensive at Ruth Crisp, so I figured out how to make it. And mine, let me tell you, I can burn. It was quite delicious. That's just an example to give you that sacrifices pay off. Because the thing about it is right now, you're in a routine that you believe that you're okay. But when somebody asks you how much money you saved up, you're like, oh, I got $500. Now, how old are you? Now, if you're 15, $500 is pretty good. You're starting off pretty good saving money. But if you're 25, with $500, now granted, if you went through hardship, if you went through a tumultuous time, if you went through a divorce, if you went through a death in the family, I understand that, guys. Believe me, I'm not oblivious to those particular events. You know, it's really straining your finances, really taking a lot away from you. So I understand, but we have to get back on track. Those things happen and we still have to live our life. So first and foremost, we need to sacrifice. Whatever it is, I need you to really screen your budget. I need to really screen your everyday routine or your monthly routine. Whatever it is, it's something in your finances that's draining them away. And it's killing you softly because you're thinking about the what? Right here and now. Because when tragedy happens in our lives, our minds begin to think, you know what? Life is precious. So let me live it every day, which could be down a road of disaster because now you're like, I'm a party hardy because you never know where you're going to go. Well, let me tell you this, we're living longer. And chances of that happening to you, depending on where you are, could be slim to none because the will to live is strong. Your body wants to live. Off of it. Here's the thing, sacrifices, make them. Figure out what it is that's draining your finances and figure out how to alter it, how to stop it, how to change it to get those funds. And once you get those funds, this is not for a vacation. This is to pay off your debt. This is for your emergency fund. This is for to invest a little, maybe $25 a month can you invest with Stash, which I really love Stash. Maybe you can only save $50 with Dollar Saving Direct. And last time I checked, their percentage was up 1.80%. I can't make you do these things. I'm only here to inform you and encourage you. Now, granted, in the description down below, I have my email. You guys can email me and ask for advice on how to go about that. And I will try my best to provide tools and any other resources you may need to get you off the ground. This is totally free, guys. Now, at first, at one point, I used to say, hey, $5, $10 for my time. Now, granted, if you have an extensive situation, $5 is not a lot for you, okay? Because it's for my time. I have a day job, okay? Got a day job. But the point I'm making is this. If you just had a simple question or you need some regular help, I'm not above approach. Go ahead and email me and we can hash this thing out via email or via phone. I have allowed a lot of subscribers to call me and help them. But here's the thing. Don't waste your time. Don't waste it. Don't waste my time. And in the same token, don't piss yourself off because you're not doing the things that you need to do. This is Ross World. In order to be where you want to be, or in order to be 10 years, 20 years, 30 years, where you want to be there, you have to make sacrifices today. It doesn't matter if you're 20 or 60. Maybe it does. It doesn't matter if you're 20 or 50. You need to make sacrifices and develop a good habit, and that takes hard work. This is Ross World. I'm out.